Welcome to Total Reddit with another new story of r/cheating stories. I am Chris Everett with you throughout the whole story. The 3-year secret and 7-year win. Before jumping the story, please hit the subscribe button to know when the next video goes live. We begin about 10 years ago when I first met David. We met through mutual friends, and we're all part of a great group of people. All of us were in college, we spent every weekend together, and David and I rapidly began to like each other and started dating. First 2 years, things were going wonderfully. We had a great relationship and began talking about moving in together when I graduated college. Around this time, David mentioned an old friend of his, Amanda, had moved back from a few states over, and he had invited her to join our group of friends. I didn't think anything of it, because of how our relationship was going. That and I had, still do, lots of guy friends. When she arrived, we quickly became good friends, and she was a great addition to our group. Over the next year, life continued and was great. Amanda was around for about 6 months, and then moved across the country to go to college. She moved back about a year later after getting pregnant, and at the same time, David and I moved in together. I had graduated college and gotten a full-time job. David and I, along with all our friends' support, who told everyone that a one-night stand didn't turn out as planned. I, along with a few other girlfriends, helped her set up a nursery and all of the things. We all pitched in when the baby came too. David and I also were getting used to living together. We had a few rocky patches agreeing over little things, but nothing major, and we always worked it out. One day, out of the blue, David decided he wanted to stay with his parents for a few days and went missing in action. Radio silence for 4 days. All my friends, including him and everyone, said David wasn't talking to them either. His parents were MIA too. He finally called and we met. We sat in a car outside of his job before he had to go to work, and he told me he was done. No explanation, just done. He didn't even come get from our apartment, which was all under me, should have been a clue, and instead sent his parents. Now, I was super stupid on this part and went back and forth with David for a month or two. We kinda had the hot-cold type thing going for that time, and lots of stuff happened. Valentine's Day was coming, and David said he wanted to take me to dinner so we could officially reconcile. He texted me that night that he was on the way to get me, then completely disappeared. I spent a very sleepless, angry night considering the past few months, but finally fell asleep. When I woke up, I scrolled social media aimlessly and ran across this. A picture of David and Amanda together, with the caption, "Best friend turns boyfriend." It had been 2 months since our breakup, after 3 years of dating. I legitimately lost my mind and did some things I won't mention here. The next few days were a haze, and when I reached out to friends for support, this great group I had always been able to rely on, they were all gone. David had fed them lies about me, and they all said they couldn't speak to me anymore. Thank goodness, I had some amazing coworkers who helped me through the next few months and over the next year, where I learned the following from the one friend who stayed. She was before the group and dealing with a breakup too. The friend who stayed, Lizzie, had remained friends with the group and Amanda and hadn't mentioned she still hung to any of them. She mentioned later she only stayed because her brother was part of the group and his GF was pregnant, so she was trying to stay amicable. She learned secrets that really blew my mind. David and Amanda announced that Amanda's baby from before our breakup was David's, and they were pregnant again. David and Amanda got married 6 months after our breakup. Amanda used to fly back every few weeks while she was away at college so that she could spend time with David. The one-night stand was a lie, and they would spend afternoons together. while I was in school thinking he was at work. They didn't tell any of the friend group, and Amanda didn't even tell her family she was in town. Amanda lied to my face the whole time. David had gone missing in action. He had actually been at her house the whole time. And our friends, except Lizzie, she was with me and didn't know about the party, had all been over to her house to celebrate there. The baby is actually David's announcement. They had all lied to my face too. His cheating and lies cost me a relationship, and he manipulated my friends so much that I lost them too. Some of which I had known before he ever met them. It took a long time to heal from those wounds. It's been 7 years since this happened, and it took me quite a while to get over it all. I am no longer angry and forgive all of them. My life is amazing, and I have been dating the right guy for a while now. Almost all of the group have reached out over the years to apologize, and I have made amends with all, except for David and Amanda. To add a bit more to the story, in January of this year, this group of friends had a reunion organized by Lizzie, who had just moved back into town after being overseas with her husband for a few years. Everyone, including David and Amanda, were there. Since amends had been made and life had moved on, it was great to see everyone. We drank and laughed and reminisced old good times. I even talked to David and Amanda, who honestly seemed a bit freaked to see me. I was polite, kind and friendly, because it's just not worth being nasty at this point, and honestly I didn't care what they thought about me, because I no longer think about them. We all started bar hopping. Lizzie, myself and a few others were pretty drunk, and having a grand time. I don't know how it happened, but I ended up sitting at a table talking to David. He, myself and one other guy talked about cars and video games for a few minutes. I got bored, so I got up to get a drink and go dance. Amanda appeared out of fits and said, "Bitch, I won, don't ever speak to him again." The laughter that came from me was legendary. Full body, tears down my face, pointing a finger at her, bent double style laughter. And she just stood there, deer in headlights look, while I laughed, composed myself, picked up my drink and walked away to go dance. I'm pretty sure I laughed loud enough that half the bar was staring at me. I am still laughing, because everyone told me that the two of them stormed out of the bar after that and Amanda was crying. I didn't say a mean word to them. Sheer presence, politeness, and laughter caused that much of a problem. Bitch, you didn't win. I did. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for the next story.